Our coast was much bigger than this much long ago, before construction of these dams. So once we started constructing big dams everywhere, we have about, I think, more than 50 dams, though we have only 42 west flowing rivers. So all this dam construction has blocked the sediment transport, this rich soil coming in, and along with the nourishments, all those things. So this has affected, first of one thing, it has affected the growth of beaches, the health of the beaches. Another thing is it has also affected the nourishment supply to the sea, which helps produce more marine, you know, fish resources and all that.
So it's kind of complex in Kerala's situation. There is more of human intervention on the coast which had impacted and the erosion had happened than due to climate change. Because it's very easy to push everything to the reason as climate change, which I don't think so.
Kerala coast has now become more vulnerable. Unprecedented winds and waves, all these things happen. So we had a cyclone very recently, which was never here, never happened here in the last about maybe in 100 years. So we had a huge cyclone, and here first time in the south, in this area, about 500 people died in the sea. That cyclone took place in the sea, unlike in the east coast. But now I am more afraid, because if such a cyclone happened in the coast, like what happened in the coast of east coast, the damage will be here will be much severe than in Andhra or Orissa, because here people live so close to the coast, the beach.
We just had our flood issues. So who can actually directly get in at the time of the disaster? The initial phase, it's naturally at the local level. And who knows what is the issue and where it's the issue and all? Who can coordinate? Though they are the unsung heroes. See, actually all these things in Kerala, how we manage the floods, one of the facilitating factors was the existence of a strong panchayat raj system.